A second one to use resolution recognizing National Authors Day. Whereas November 1st is National Authors Day, which gives you the opportunity to take a moment to appreciate the authors that spend countless hours writing your favorite books. And whereas it's important to get a sense of time, love, and friendship that goes into getting words on the page. And whereas the question is raised, what is an author? They are creators through and through. They are writers who both inspire us, from William Shakespeare being the most famous of all authors, all the way to J.K. Rowling and Stephen King. And whereas Schenectady has produced a number of authors, including John W. Ball, who created the character Richard Tears, that was a human life, Carlos Pat Kennedy, Carlos Caraballo, Macy Collins, William D. Jr., Allison Depp Fortune, Nikki Lutowski, I'm not sure, Michael Gizzi, Anne Winter, Arnold Mitchell, Marshall Mortimer, Ray Nelson, William B. Patrick, John M. Connery, Joseph M. Culver Sr., Elizabeth Rothschild, Michael M. Rothschild, Edward Sarah Richards, and John Fyler, to name a few. And whereas, regardless of the time period they are from, authors have always been ahead of those who reach, teach, entertain, and progress. Now, therefore, be resolved that the mayor, Gary R. McCarthy, and the city council, signify our pause in their deliberation to recognize National Authors Day and the many authors who were born or resolved in Schenectady. I'd like to move the resolution.
Some cases, the kids in that household may not be comfortable expressing love verbally or Thank you very much for the recognition. Just one thing, when you wrote a book about Troy, the city government had a lot of reasons to deny it. So here, I haven't even published the book about Schenectady yet. You already know it's going to be. The resolution recognizing the Alpha 1 and Rainbow 1. Thank you. the function of the city. Challenges, but right now the delegates, of course, the challenges for everybody's job, but it's challenges as well. excited to have this opportunity. I just wanted to get a chance to get out here. As we quickly are approaching the holiday season, one of the things that we're really proud that we do every year is provide activities for people to come to downtown. So a few things that I just want to give you an update on. This coming, we'll be making a formal announcement tomorrow morning with the Capital Region Chamber, but this coming Saturday is Small Business Friendly Day. That's a good year ago. And it's a whole reason to come out. If you do it every day of the year, but it's a reason to really start to spotlight on the great local independent businesses that we have here in this community. So I really do encourage you to come out on Saturday and throughout the year to support our great local business owners. And then coming up on Saturday, December 7th, we actually have three back-to-back, actually simultaneous events that are happening here in downtown from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. is the 3rd annual holiday bazaar that we're doing with the District Business Association, where we'll be having some, all the businesses in downtown will be involved, having great special activities. We'll be having some vendors in the on Franklin Street as well. And from noon to 4 a.m. we're also having, we'll have great activities for families in Schenectady to come for free for the entire afternoon. And then the third afternoon, the fifth annual Chili Chow Gathering will be happening before and after 17 different restaurants, I believe, around downtown will be doing that activity. So again, just a great idea of activities with a lot coming up in the holiday season to enjoy here on downtown Schenectady. Again, thank you for your support currently throughout the years. We look forward to joining even more for all the businesses and all the folks who enjoy our time today.
Thank you so much.
My name is Rebecca Grant. I'm the statewide organizer for Housing Justice with Citizen Action and the upstate coordinator for the Housing Justice for All campaign. I am here this evening to talk a little bit about the housing legislation that was passed in June, to clear up any misconceptions about what that was and what that wasn't, and to talk about what is still needed to protect the residents of Schenectady and ensure that everyone in Schenectady can access safe and affordable housing. So, the Housing Stability and Income Protection Act passed in June includes the two most impactful things for upstate within the city of Schenectady were the removal of geographic restrictions of USPA, which is a rent stabilization system that used to only exist in our city and three surrounding counties. And now, any municipality in upstate that meets the criteria can object to it. In addition, there were a package of certain protections that, when added together, are fairly impactful for renters across the state. Some highlights of those are that security deposits cannot be more than the equivalent of 1 month's rent, and application fees are capped at $20. What we did not was last legislative session was good cause eviction. That was one bill that was part of our platform that we did not win. Now, I know some misinformation was brought forth to this council at a previous meeting, and I want to clarify that. So, under the current legislation, it was perfectly legal to evict someone false evictions or legal mistakes that have been and then still home. I have good false eviction facts. It would still give a property owner the right to evict someone for cause. So if you have someone who has paid their rent, if you have someone who was conducting an activity at a residence that was either illegal or nuisance, a property owner would still have the right for eviction. What that piece of legislation does that we are asking for, that's enormously impactful, is it gives tenants the right to advocate for unsafe and inhumane repairs regarding the conditions they live in without the fear of a retaliation for eviction. And it protects them against displacement from development of luxury houses. So we are looking for the council to call on all the elected officials that represent you all to maintain the integrity of the HSTPA, to pass the cause next year, and to pass the Home Stability Support Act, which would provide a rent supplement for those at risk of eviction and homelessness. And I know that is not, but I want to present to the council with a resolution that we have prepared, which does that, and I would like you to consider it. Thank you.
implemented because that does not need to happen in the United States. But I want to delve a little bit into Schenectady because this is my community, this is my home. Anyway, I want to thank you guys and all the council that this resolution is going to be passed. You need to have good qualification. I myself was in a situation with my landlord where my son's out there. There was broken gravel and I had to ask the place for enough for him to fix things. It wasn't being done because my landlord wasn't able to do this. My landlord. Comes to find out that there was someone and I was receiving mail from a start of a program on this and I'm wondering, what is this? You're not my lady. So, this happened more than once. It was fixed out at the local program, but it's not fixed. It's really done to stand up for us because even though we are trying our best to make repayments, that doesn't mean the landlord's the right to have a lot. Evicted just because the rental agent takes his deal without any just cause. It's not right for them to not take care of their property and be recorded to the city to say, this isn't right. They don't fix the property, but we still get evicted. Where is that thing? It is not so out of the action. The city council can pass this resolution, please and thank you.
Just briefly
Assistance for that, for the repairs to be made. How is the
becomes aware that they didn't. And so she ended up not holding rent in an effort to try to get them to make the repayment. Now, again, we don't have good cause eviction, and so the landlord immediately took her to court to resist her for not paying the rent, the same one that she said, I'm not going to pay my rent. So she wasn't even 30 days late yet. Luckily, she was able to get in front of a judge who heard what she had to say and was trying to do work that she was trying to be fair to her. And the ultimate result was that the judge said, you should be off from there, and I'm giving you the time it takes you to find a new place to live, and you don't have to take any rent, and neither do any of the other tenants in that building, given the disrepair of that building. So that was 4 months it took her to move. So the downside of that is the landlord was not forced to repair anything. And that building is continuing to be rented. And Diane tells me that he hears from tenants in that building that they're continuing to be listed. So like the others, I urge the council to really look at this resolution, to think about good cause eviction, and then send the other legislation in place to further protect tenants. Thank you.
Ago, I was counseling on the alphabet,
Thank you. Thank you.